Welcome. My name is Jeffrey Kerosi and
I'm Walter Maina.
Today we are going to discuss and affairs. The United Nations World Food Program is planning to cut rations for refugees in Kenya. United Nations World Food Program is cutting these rations by 30% for over 400,000 refugees living in Kenyan camps as a result of insufficient funding.
The United Nations really lack funds.
I was also wondering about it because we think of United Nations as a savior, a big body agency, which should be coming with plenty of funds.
Yeah.
But it is unfortunate that they are announcing that they are going to make cuttings or they will reduce the amount of food they send to the refugee camps in Kenya.
Okay, did they give any reason for their insufficiency of funds?
Basically, they gave a statement today.
Yeah.
As you know, today is 2nd of October,
yeah,
of 2017. And it's a Monday. Today, they gave a statement announcing that they are going to cut food rations because of insufficient funding. So further, they stated that there are two refugee camps in Kenya. Do you know them?
I know of Dadaab,
Dadaab.
I don't know whether it has been closed yet.
People were asked, those refugees were asked to move or to go back home voluntarily. And you know Dadaab is located in Garissa County. So they were asked, can you go back home? Then it was called the repatriation of refugees. Repatriation is to be moved from one country where you are a refugee to your home country. And they had set aside some billions of money for that. I think, was it 1 billion? Do you remember?
I'm not sure of the funds.
It was something like 1 billion shillings, which was set aside during the time of Nkaiseri, the former minister for internal security. Some of the refugees were repatriated back home, but there are those who said that it's not safe for us to go back home. So they are still at the Dadaab refugee camp.
Yeah.
And we have another refugee camp in Turkana. Do you know the name of that refugee camp?
No.
We have a refugee camp in Turkana in a place called Kakuma. So there is one, you know, Kakuma is towards the northwestern part. It's in Turkana County.
Yeah.
While the Dadaab refugee camp is in Garissa County.
Yeah.
So they are in the opposite parts of the country, but towards the north.
Yeah.
Dadaab refugee camp mostly hosts refugees from Somalia. And do you know why they come to Kenya?
Okay.
Refugees from Somalia?
Because in Kenya they believe that there is peace and their country has always been warring.
Yes, Somalia has been in war. There is the aspect of having terrorists. The Al-Qaeda. Is it Al-Qaeda? No. It is called Al-Shabaab. Al-Shabaab is based in Somalia. So people feel unsafe in Somalia. So they move to the neighboring countries. So in this case, there are Somalis in Kenya refugee camps. But Kenya is not the only place which hosts refugees. So you can find Somalis everywhere around the world.
Yeah.
If you go to the United States, there are Somalis there. If you go to South Africa, there are Somalis there. And do you know what they do for a living? Most of them. They are businessmen. Since we are broadcasting live from the city, you know, here in the city, there is a small Mogadishu.
Yeah.
It is called Isiri. Isiri is a small Mogadishu because there are so many Somalis there. And some of these Somalis come from Somalia, the country, our neighboring country. So it is a clear fact that Somalis are everywhere.
Yeah.
Those who have gone to the United States, they have also indicated that there are several Somalis there. So for these two refugee camps, both Dadaab and Kakuma, they host refugees from both Somalia and Southern Sudan.
Yeah.
So if we have said that most Somalis or Somali refugees are in Dadaab, then it's automatic that most refugees in Kakuma
could be
to the northwest are most likely they are from Southern Sudan. So those guys, why do they run from Southern Sudan?
South Sudan is one of the youngest countries in Africa. It's actually the youngest country in Africa,
mm-hmm.
but it has been recently faced by war.
Mm-hmm.
Even their president was residing here in Nairobi.
Actually, most Southern Sudanese,
mm.
those people we call Herites, mm. those who have money mm. and those who have power,
mm.
they have second homes in Nairobi.
Mm.
When things are hot in their home country,
yeah.
in what's the capital of city of Southern Sudan? It is called Juba.
Yeah.
When things are not good in Juba,
mm.
they come to Nairobi. And most of them I discovered also that their children are here in Nairobi.
Yeah.
They have children in these posh areas like Greresho, Arvington, that's where they stay.
Mm.
So what we are saying is that these two refugee camps, one hosting refugees from Somalia, which is Dadaab, another one hosting refugees from
South Sudan.
It's because of these two countries are ravaged by wars, which force residents to flee.
Yeah.
You cannot stay in a country where there is war.
People need peace for them too.
People need peace, and no one wants to die.
Yeah.
So they run away from their countries to Kenya. If there is war, for example, in Kenya, we would run away. We would have to run away to Uganda,
Tanzania.
But God forbid.
Yeah.
God forbid. We don't want to run away.
Yeah.
We want to be peaceful. We want to have a peaceful country where we stay in peace with everyone else.
Yeah.
We don't want even this election to divide us.
Yeah.
We don't want to fight the way we did in 2007. So it is our responsibility to keep peace so that we stay in peace and we don't become refugees.
Yeah.
If you are displaced from a country because of war and you settle within the same country in refugee camps or in a camp, you are called internally displaced person.
Yeah.
But if you are displaced and you move to the neighboring country, you are called a refugee. So an internally displaced person is a refugee in your own country.
His or her own country.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But if you are displaced and you run away to a neighboring country or a country far away, then you automatically become a refugee. So the United Nations World Food Program needed 28.5 million US dollars. That's a lot of money.
But to the UN, that's little money.
That is pocket change.
Yeah. To the UN, 28.5 million
is pocket
US change. Dollars is little money.
Little money.
Yeah.
But to us, it's a lot of money.
Yeah. To the economy because of Kenya,
it if is we huge. Say the exchange rate is $1 for 100 shillings.
Yeah. Roughly.
Then you are given 1 million US dollars. How much is that in Kenyan shilling?
You would be having 100 million.
100 Kenyan million. Shillings. Needed. Actually, the World Food Program needed 28.5 million to provide food rations for there are an actual number of 420,000 refugees who are living in Kenya or in Kakuma and Dadaab. And that money will only provide food for how many years?
For half a year.
Half a year.
Yeah.
That's 6 months.
For 6 months, the refugees could consume the 28.5 million US dollars.
It looks a lot of money.
But the United Nations could support that, and we when you have a number of refugees, that means those people are really have faith in the peace in your country.
Exactly.
So this is a good image to the country Kenya outside there. Now the United Nations could just allocate that funds and continue feeding the refugees in Dadaab and Kakuma.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, United Nations is a world respected body. When things go wrong, for example, if a country fails, a failed country is called a banana republic.
Yeah.
If a country fails, we run to the United Nations. When there was a problem in Rwanda during the genocide in 1994, I guess, what happened? They were pointing fingers at the United Nations.
Yeah.
They were saying, why didn't you do something to prevent this genocide? So this means that United Nations is our last resort where we should find peace, where we should find food if we are in hunger. So this is a huge body which is highly respected and is supposed to bring peace and harmony amongst the world population.
Yeah.
But if you find that they cannot afford to provide food for refugees in Kenya and Uganda, remember they are the same United Nations World Food Program who are feeding people in other countries where there is war, like Syria. We have war. Where else do we have war? Syria. There are other countries which are at war. or country, actually many countries have refugees.
Mm.
And these refugees have to eat, they have to wear clothes, they have to, their children have to go to school. But the World Food Program majorly provides the food. Then there are other UN agencies like UNICEF, which provides what? Education for children. Then there is United Women, for example, United Nations Women, or UN Women. Probably they deal with the empowering women in those refugee camps. So if they cannot be able to feed our refugees in Kenya, what message are they sending to the world?
They are probably raising up their hands that they have failed, or they are withdrawing from their own mandate.
So should we have an alternative? Maybe we create a new world agency which provides better help. It is good time now. It looks like this monopoly they have been enjoying is not working for them.
Yeah, we can
probably we need another United Nations.
Yeah, we can mobilize those developed countries so that they start their own funding.
A different United Nations.
Yeah, that will be helping.
United Nations in quotes.
Yeah.
It can be even called United Countries.
Yeah.
Then they compete. Yeah. They are put in the level ground, in the field ground. They are left to compete.
Yeah.
I think the United Nations then will improve their services.
They improve their service and really take up their mandate. And
The party which performs better, which is more efficient, will be given more money because they are able to deliver.
Yeah.
But this kind of business of leaving some bodies to have a lot of... a lot of monopoly. Freedom, a lot of monopoly, makes them, I don't know which word I can use, makes them relax.
Yeah.
They don't look for more resources. They should mobilize for more money.
Yeah.
If they want more money, they can even ask member countries to contribute more.
No, they have the resources.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, probably there could be something.
Or they have reallocated resources to something else.
Yeah.
Probably to peacekeeping. Yeah, because you know they are also doing peacekeeping in Somalia. Okay, that's the end of this episode. That's what happened today. The senior officials in Kenya, in charge of the United Nations World Food Program, made this announcement. Up to this point, we will say thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel. There is a subscription button below. Make sure you subscribe. And also pass this message. Share these videos. Share them with your friends. Let them also know what's going on. Kerosi TV is a global web-based TV program where we discuss current affairs, we discuss public policy, and even weird news. And remember, there is no topic under the sun that is a no-go zone. We discuss everything. This is Naked Truth. Thank you for watching. Thank you for tuning in. See you next time on the internet.
Thank you.
Thank you.